How's it going from the KOA here in Fairbanks, Alaska? Almost at the end of our Alaska trip. So we got to the KOA here on Monday, and immediately we had to sit down and start editing for this week's video. But it's Thursday. It's Thanks Thursday. Our video just released. As you can see, I got Carl behind me getting everything ready because we're going somewhere awesome today.
Knock, knock. Call the boy where we're going. Where are we going? Is he gonna wanna go with us? Yes.
I'll tell you in a second. Whenever we talk to the locals and we say, what do we need to do while we're in Fairbanks? So many people are like, you gotta go to the Chena Hot Springs. Chena? Chena? Which one is it? Yikes. So you know what we're gonna do today?
What?
We're going to Costco! There's something that happens that you lack when you go into the RV world. And one of those things is a bathtub. And a great tip for you, if you're a person that likes to soak in a hot tub or some kind of spring, is look around in your travels or travel to places that have like public hot springs, because that's the best you're gonna get.
I'm sorry, did I hear you say there aren't that many RVs out there with a bathtub?
I know you're about to say there are some.
No, you worded it like there are some.
Yes, there are some.
What? I never heard of this.
I mean, it's very, very rare and far and few between, but some models have a bathtub.
Why are we not on this level? We need to make this happen.
He's just learning this now, and I feel like we're about to sell this rig and get one with a bathtub.
Stay tuned. This weekend, rig's going up for sale.
Is the foot bath not enough?
It's not enough.
Ooh, we are off to the races. Listen, I'm turned this way because there's something in the back seat that we want to show you guys, but I don't want to show you right now. So stop, don't look, stop. Oh, maybe I should turn this way. I don't know my orientation. There's something we need to show you, and we're gonna show you in this video. Oh crap, we just got a missed call and they left a voicemail. And that makes me nervous because we just left the campground, and sometimes you never know if it's the campground being like, hey, your water just spewed everywhere. So let's see who called.
Hi there, this call is to remind you that 50% discount offer on your Comcast Xfinity account expires today. In order to avail the discount, please call back at...
Don't you just love those voicemails? Don't you just love it? Hashtag relatable. The Santa Claus house. I have an idea.
That's dangerous.
We're going to the Santa Claus house, and we're gonna purchase one item that we're gonna use in the RV for Christmas. That's more of a reason to stick around than what we have to show you in the back seat. What will I get at the Santa Claus house? We got the running reindeer ranch. We got dog sledding, which we have done dog sledding. And if you haven't seen that video, make sure you check it out. You got the sunscreen?
I got my backpack.
We're
did
ready.
You pack sunscreen?
No.
I wouldn't put it past you.
We're in Alaska. We don't need it. I get so nervous filming in public. Like I'm one of those tourists with the camera, you know? That's what I'm doing right
hey,
now.
You filming in hey. Public?
Yet another cloudy day here in the Hanks household.
That's okay, we're gonna go out anyways. We're gonna make Alaska experience what we want it to be. You know what I'm saying? You gotta take it by the horns and go with it. Not too much going on up here, as you can see. Rocking a little chitty chitty bang bang on the TV here and doing some puzzles. You guys ever seen that movie? It's a good one if you haven't. Made in the late 60s, I won't bore you with the details. Just go watch it. I forgot to mention yesterday after we left the Chena Hot Springs, we rolled up on this road. Oh my goodness, blew our minds. I'll just have to show you.
It's too good to pass up. We're going back. You guys are never gonna believe what road we just crossed by. Oh my gosh. We're almost there.
This is just too good to be true. No stinking way.
We're home.
Yes way, nay, nay. That is awesome. If we ever build a house one day or something weird like that, when we stop living this RV life, we're naming our road that road. It's official. We're doing it.
Isn't that crazy? What are the chances that that would happen? We'll continue to rock that. Maybe we can get like a replica of that sign made and then hang it in the camper here. People would be like, that's not a real road. And be like, try again. Yes, it is. Still have that huge surprise that we want to share with you guys. It's in the back of the truck. I have been just... No, it's not a kid. I didn't leave a kid in the back of the... What is wrong with you guys? No, it's not... I can't tell you. You're trying to get me to spill the beans. I know it. I know your techniques. Oh, I'm gonna give a few more minutes. I gotta go ask Nay if I could tell you guys. I'm trying here, okay? I'm trying my best. Nay, you ready to go?
I wanna look good for Santa Claus. Excuse me. I'm not ready yet. Look at this.
You look beautiful.
Gosh, you're so sweet.
We went to Pagoda last night. It's a local Chinese restaurant in the North Pole. Yeah, they have Chinese food up in the North Pole. It's pretty cool. The weird thing about being up here in Fairbanks, Alaska is there's not much of a selection of restaurants up here. They don't go above and beyond of making these extravagant restaurants, and I don't know if it's because of the location of being here in Alaska. Mostly it's just been fancy feasts on the menu, however. I mean, I'm not naming names, but... It is a demanding meal to be fed every day. In all seriousness though, the reason I bring up this restaurant, the Pagoda, Guy Fieri. You know that guy? That guy, Guy Fieri, on TV with the blonde spiky hair that does all the restaurants. He ate here one time and he said it was amazing. So I'm basically related to him now. I don't want to brag too much, but yeah, we got a connection there. All right, give it to me real here, Nene. Game plan for today. What are the deets? Lay it out.
Well, here's what I think. We go get some crepes and then we go to the Santa Claus house. Our goal today is to buy one thing Christmassy for the RV. And I don't know what they even have there. So here we go.
All right, let's do it. So this is what the outdoors feels like.
Ooh, I don't like it.
Let's go back
let's
in.
Let's go back in.
Wow, babe, look, we're in Candyland. That quick.
No, honey, they're candy cane poles. It's Christmas.
It's close enough. It's been a minute since I had a crepe. And let me just say, a crepe, if you never had one, you need to try it. Like a thin pancake that's really sweet and savory. It's not just good, it's crepe. Let that sink in for a second.
You're done.
Quite the contrary. I'm just getting started.
I am so sorry. I just drank the rest of this.
No, you're not.
He's right. Hashtag marriage life. There ain't no Karen when you're Sharon. This challenge we're doing where we're gonna find an item for the RV, to say the least, a bit of a challenge, I should say.
Why?
In itself. Because when you live in an RV, you don't have much space, and when you wanna decorate, it's not that you don't have space to hang up your decorations, it's the space of storing it the other 11 months out of the year. Or if you're like me, 10 months out of the year, because I get the decorations out before Thanksgiving.
And we've been doing this for 6 years. And I've been putting up with 6 years of your nonsense.
Mm-hmm.
Just kidding, it's my nonsense too.
Right.
You're right, this is a challenge. Is Santa Claus ready for the RV life? We'll see. We've literally been searching for days and we finally found potentially a place to drop off some clothes. I don't know about you guys, but being out on the road full time, trying to like offload some of your old stuff, it's no easy feat. Finding those clothes bins out in the parking lots, you know what I'm talking about. That's hard enough to find. And then on top of it, you can't even open the bin because it's so stuffed full of people's old clothes. That is a real struggle. And we're dealing with it right now. It's a lot of weight, folks. These clothes, they don't mess around. You don't believe me that clothes weigh a lot? Try to gather up some of your old clothes and you tell me.
Are they taking them?
Yes.
You want some help carrying?
I'm good.
I'll wait here.
Okay, this is all I have.
Thank you. She's the best. And I officially feel a lot more at ease. The pressure's off. Getting rid of old stuff feels great. Santa Claus, we're coming for you.
Oh, there's RV parking. There's RV parking. We could have brought Dexter. He could have been in the RV. The building looks like Christmas. Who would have thought?
Santa!
What a plot twist.
Now I understand why people say this is hard to miss. Makes sense.
It was like an Alliance caravan happening.
What's up with that? Why weren't we invited?
Hey now.
Hey, how's it going?
I already lost Nene.
I was looking all over for you because I wanted to be like, this is barely the beginning. I mean, everything down there. It's amazing.
Stay right here within arm's reach.
No, I will not. What to get? What to get? No, you're not part of this. I'll look.
Oh, okay. Well, I'll just go.
What
hey,
to
so
get?
I was thinking.
I don't think this is it.
We can't take the easy route out. A coffee mug, easy.
Too easy.
Hand towel, too easy.
Too easy.
We gotta figure out something that sticks out a little bit more. Says we've been here, but we're not like overwhelming ourselves.
Okay. I wanted a coffee mug.
Five, four, three, two.
No, not yet. I want you to point to somebody in your living room right now that needs this from Santa Claus. If you know, you know.
Dexter, come feeding time. Okay, keep an open mind here. I want you to be really objective. Let me know if this is too much. Will this work? Is this too much?
I think we can fit it outside.
We got plenty of passengers for it.
Yeah, okay. The key to picking out the right item for the RV is you want to make sure it's big enough that it stands out, but small enough that it stores. It's a tough one.
I'm just throwing it out there. Don't get your hopes up. I mean, look at her. She looks like a lost puppy dog.
They even have, like, benches for husbands to sit at when their wife is looking around too long. And I'm just gonna say, I'm pretty sure this guy's waiting for a spot to open up.
I took a number and they haven't called
my bench.
Number. They haven't called my number yet.
Give me an update. What do you think about choosing an item?
This is a lot of pressure. So much pressure. I don't know where I stand with everything yet. It's too soon.
Okay, I know I said Christmas item, but did you know they have Halloween stuff here?
Which I think is fair to bring up this topic. You're more of Halloween, I'm more Christmas. So I'm not gonna put you guys in that awkward situation, but I'm definitely gonna ask, is it Christmas or Halloween for you guys? What team are you on? Don't pick the wrong team, but no pressure, just pick.
Honey.
Yeah.
Santa Claus is here, I'm just saying.
I saw him, okay, and I wasn't gonna bring it up because I'm nervous.
I am nervous too, like.
Santa's
here! So exciting, I didn't know if I was gonna see him here.
You have to go buy all this stuff and then I'm the one that has to carry it all around.
Yeah! How'd you think we did?
Based on this little thing, I think we did pretty good.
There was a lot of damage I could have done in there. Like I said, tough decision, but here we go. Ta-da! We got like these cute like block signs where you can stand them up on a table or you can hang them on the wall.
It's upside down.
Sorry.
There we go. I picked this one, better not pout. And then she got that one.
I got this one. And I know we got two things, but it's the same category.
We didn't want to go all big and we got two lightweight things, which I'm really thankful for.
This is not going to throw us over our payload. Yeah, because it is bulky, but they lay flat. So if you put this in the bottom of a bin. Wait, what about that other Christmas gift that we got ourselves early a couple days ago? Are we gonna be showing them that soon? We gotta go home first.
Well, it's raining and we're on the road. We just said goodbye to Fairbanks. I think this is almost goodbye to Alaska, actually. However, I am not bummed about what I'm gonna show you guys here in just a second. Actually, you guys have been waiting enough. You're so patient. Teach me your ways of how you become so patient in life. I need to take notes. because RV life is always testing your patience. Behold, without further ado, yeah. You see it? See it? Right there.
Read it and weep.
It's a display unit. It was the last of its kind. We went to Sportsman Warehouse here in Fairbanks. We made the decision kind of on a whim that, look, we're gonna be heading down south through Canada and we have tons of boondocking opportunities. Now, if you remember in the previous episode where we went boondocking for a whole weekend in Denali, like National Park area, we ran into some concerns of having those batteries become fully depleted without any way of recharging them back up. Hence, this is where the generator comes in. Now, I know what you're thinking. You're thinking, wow, Hanks, you're throwing a lot of money into this. And yeah, you're totally right. That generator, it was pricey. I think we paid $2,500 out the door for it. My favorite thing about going forward with this is you're recognizing how much money we're putting into these things. And I want to be open with you guys that, yeah, it's pricey. But what I really want to show you guys is how long does it take to make that return on investment? Basically meaning how many nights of boondocking will it take to make up that money rather than spending it on like an RV park? Does that make sense? We spend it on a generator. Now, how many nights is it gonna take to make up for it? We're gonna give you all those details as we go forward. Generator hasn't even left the box yet. I bought oil for it. I bought a stabilizer for the gas just in case we go for extended periods of time without using it. I haven't even fired it up yet, but I did do the responsible adult thing and I signed up for the warranty on it. So can I get a little kudos for that? I appreciate that. Thank you so much. It's a Honda. The reason we went with Honda is a big concern of ours was when we do get out boondocking, we want to ensure that we have a quiet generator. And word on the market is that Honda is kind of leading that realm. But now that we have this, I want to make sure we take baby steps as we go along to make sure you guys have the information you need going forth. Do you really need all these batteries? Do you need all these inverters and generators and all that? Well, we're going to take it slowly but surely, and you can make that decision as we go along. Listen, we have so much more to explore with this generator. I'm going to show you how it all works. We're going to learn together. We're going to fire it up together. And that's all forthcoming in videos. But if you're waiting for that video to come out, we would really appreciate your support by going back and watching some of our older content, even if you've already seen them, rewatch them, because hey, it supports us more than you could ever know. We love you guys. We'll see you next Thursday. You know where to find us. It's the Hanks family. We're out of here. Bye.